Hey there, quirky folks. I'm your host, Anna, and today we'll be looking at potential candidates for yet another Batman. Many would agree that there have been too many live-action Batmen already. Robert Pattinson should have been the last one. After him, we probably had room for just one more Batman, and that's Terry McGinnis, aka Batman Beyond. But that movie has been canceled, and James Gunn is coming up with another DCU reboot. He has confirmed that Batman will play a crucial role in this new franchise. On top of that, both Gunn and Matt Reeves also confirmed that Robert Pattinson's Batman will be separate from the new DCU. So, we can be sure that a new Batman will come in to replace Ben Affleck and Michael Keaton after The Flash. But before we look at the potential candidates to be the next Batman, it would be nice if you guys would hit those like and subscribe buttons. With that out of the way, I'd like to proceed with my first pick for Batman, and that's Alan Ritson. Since Pattinson's Cape Crusader is in his early days, Gunn could go on a different path. He could use an experienced Batman who is in his prime, but isn't very old. And I think Alan Ritson is just perfect for that. So far, he has been known for playing Hawk on DC's Titan and Jack Reacher on Prime Video's Reacher. He is also set to play one of the villains in Fast X. But this big guy could be an insanely badass Batman, and he proved that with Reacher. He has an amazing face for Bruce Wayne that will totally remind you of Batman the Animated Series and Batman from the original Justice League Animated Series.
You're a princess from a society of immortal warriors. I'm a rich kid with issues. Lots of issues.
And his physique is exactly what a bulky comic accurate Batman would need. So, he is my first pick for Batman. And if not him, then I'd like to present my second choice, Jensen Ackles. So far, people have loved Jensen Ackles in Supernatural. But many fans had newfound love for his portrayal of Soldier Boys in The Boys. His voice would actually be quite awesome for Batman.
You're that asshole from the lab.
In fact, most of you would be aware that he has already voiced the Dark Knight in Batman: The Long Halloween Parts 1 and 2.
You thought wrong. You and your San Ho Hui buddies were seen outside Harvey Dent's house on Halloween.
So, there's your cue for casting him as Batman, Mr. James Gunn. Make it happen, because he is still just 44 years old and could carry on for the next 10 to 12 years. He isn't as bulky as Alan Ritson, but many would agree that he is a superior actor. So, he'd be a great choice for Batman as well. But if James Gunn is looking for even bigger A-listers, then he could go for Jake Gyllenhaal. Back when Matt Reeves was casting his Batman, a name that was thrown around quite often was of Jake Gyllenhaal. In fact, the Mysterio actor was also considered back when Christopher Nolan was coming up with Batman Begins. Even now, Gyllenhaal is just 42. We thought that he could have returned as Mysterio in No Way Home. But now, it does seem that he is done with the MCU. So, James Gunn could certainly pick him up as the biggest name in his DCU movies. Many would agree that Gyllenhaal is among the best candidates to be Batman. But if you're not among them, then you could maybe look at Josh Hartnett. Here's another name that has been tossed around quite often when it comes to casting a new Batman. That's because Josh Hartnett was actually offered the part back when Batman Begins was under development. He declined the opportunity and has regretted doing that ever since. But his recent bit in Operation Fortune showed that he still has the charisma and talent to be both Bruce Wayne and Batman. So, he could be a nice pick in the 44-year-old actor's range. But if Gunn is looking to start with a young Batman just like his Superman, then he could try out Nicholas Holt. This 33-year-old actor is known for playing Beast in the X-Men movies. But people also loved him in Mad Max Fury Road.
I live, I die, I live again!
And recently when Matt Reeves was looking to cast as Batman, the choice was between Holt and Pattinson. So, it's needless to say that Holt is really fond of the character and would surely like to play the part. While he certainly has the talent to play a broken Bruce Wayne, one could argue that he is quite skinny. Again, that could be fixed with a good workout regimen. But we already have a young, skinny, and brooding Batman in Robert Pattinson. Why would James Gunn want to offer something that's totally similar? Nicholas Holt would be a great Batman Beyond, but I think he shouldn't be the main Batman of DCU. Instead, James Gunn could look at Reggae Jean Page. He became a huge deal after Netflix's Bridgerton turned out to be a major success, although it is quite sad that he left the show. But his fans might love it if he ends up playing Batman. A race bent Bruce Wayne has been talked about in the past, but it hasn't been done so far. Till now, James Gunn's casting choices have been quite amazing. And he also has the kind of innovative, out-of-the-box thinking that a filmmaker should. Since he had the guts to reboot the entire DCEU, I believe that he could also cast a non-white actor to be Batman. And if that's the case, then Reggae Jean Page could be his choice. But if not him, then he could also look at John David Washington. Here's another huge pick if James Gunn wants to give us a race-bent Batman. John David Washington proved his mettle in Tenet, and it's about time he got something big. So far, he hasn't really found any major success after Tenet, as he starred in movies like Amsterdam and Malcolm and Marie. But all that could be changed if he ends up becoming the next Bruce Wayne. Although, you can't deny the fact that there would be a huge fan outcry if Gunn actually picks up an actor of color for Batman. The fans still won't be ready for that, so Gunn should probably look at John David Washington for Green Lantern instead. And as far as Batman is concerned, he could pick Carl Urban. This guy has truly impressed us as Billy Butcher and the Boys. But even before the Boys, he starred in multiple amazing roles such as Judge Dredd, a hitman in the Bourne Supremacy, Dr. Leonard McCoy in the Star Trek franchise, and the Executioner in Thor Ragnarok. So he surely has the talent to play Batman. It would be an even bigger role for him than Billy Butcher, but he is 50 years old, so that might push him out of the consideration. Instead, James Gunn could look at Richard Madden. The former Game of Thrones star played a Superman counterpart in the MCU. Many would argue that Eternals only became watchable because of Richard Madden's performance as Icarus. But since it was probably a one-and-done role for him, he could go on to pick up a DC character. And now that Batman is up for grabs, he'd be another good choice for the gig. Although, he'd have to work on his heavy Scottish accent.
Neither Joffrey nor any of his men shall set foot in our lands again if he disregards this command.
But if you don't prefer him either, then my final pick for the list is Jamie Dornan. The 50 Shades franchise star is also known for his performance in the crime thriller series called The Fall. And those who saw 2019 Synchronic would agree that he deserves a shot in the superhero genre. In 2022, Dornan also starred in another thriller series called The Tourist. But I'd say that he'd be a very strong choice for Batman too. He has only entered the 40s and has a great physique, which would work perfectly for a role like Batman. So I'd say go for Dornan, Mr. Gunn. Okay, so these were my picks for Batman and James Gunn's DCU. Which of these actors do you think should get the part? Let us know in the comments. And once again, don't forget to click on those like and subscribe buttons. Goodbye, and I'll see you in the next one.